Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining us today. And we're going to do another video on Connie's campfire cooking. Well, Lonnie and I have had our lunch, and now we thought we would just show you a little kind of a dessert that we like to do. So what we're going to do here is bake an apple in the coals, and I'm going to show you how we do it anyway. So Lonnie's got me a nice board to chop on here. I already washed this apple at home. So right now I'm just quartering and coring. This is a big apple, and we ate a lot for lunch, so we're just going to do one and share it. I like to leave the skins on. Everybody's got their preference. You can do whatever you want. And this happened to be a gala apple, but that certainly doesn't matter. Use whatever you like. Okay, now I'm going to just slice and do thin slices. I think it'll cook up faster that way. So once we get this all sliced up, we'll come back and show you what we do next. Okay, we've got part of our apple sliced into here. It was such a huge apple, we couldn't fit it all. So I've only got half of that apple that you saw in here. I know it'll cook down, but I want to have enough room to fold my foil up good. And so we've got two layers of aluminum foil. And I like the heavy duty. If you're going to be cooking in the campfire ashes, it just seems to hold up a little bit better. So next I'm going to put on some cinnamon. Stir that up a little bit. Get it mixed up with all the apples a little more. Okay, and then what we're going to do is just put some butter on there. A few pats of butter. And then we're just going to let it cook in its own juices. You could add sugar if you want, but we think it's plenty sweet. The apple's plenty sweet without it. And when it cooks up, it should be very buttery, cinnamony, and juicy. Okay. Now, as you can see, we've got two layers of foil here. So we're going to wrap the first one first. And just a real small little fold. Once, twice, another small fold. And then three times if you've got the room. Looks like we just do. Then the ends, the same way, small folds. One, two, three.
That's to help hold in all the juices. Kind of make a pocket, packet. Same with the second piece. You can bunch them up more, but we spread them out a little more. Hopefully they'll cook better. So now Lonnie's going to help me get the coals ready and the fire, and so we're going to switch places, and you can see how we place it in the fire. We've let our fire burn down to just coals, so Lonnie's going to scoop out a spot in the middle to put our packet in. Then he's going to put coals all back up around it and beside it, over it, and kind of create like an oven effect. Scooting the logs in a little bit closer for heat on the sides. Okay, we'll time it, and then we'll let you know how long it took to bake. All right, it's been buried in the coals there for 25 minutes. So Lonnie is going to get it out for us. Doesn't look like there was any leakage, which is good. You can tell he's got leather gloves on, which is a good thing when you're working with this hot stuff. So we're just going to leave it here to cool for a bit before we start to unwrap it. Well, hopefully this has cooled down enough now, so let's open it up and see what it looks like. One reason for double wrapping is to, in case you puncture, which I did puncture the first layer when I was stirring it with a stick, but the second layer was not punctured, so it doesn't look like we lost any juices that way. Goodness, taking a while to get into. Very nice. Smidgen of burn on the end, but that's okay. It's very well cooked. Oh, it looks wonderful. So let's get some on our plates here. That little bit of burnt won't matter. My mom used to always say, a little charcoal never hurt nobody. That's our motto when we're cooking over a campfire. So all the juices stayed in. And looks wonderful. I'll go ahead and do my taste test, and then we'll let Lonnie have a taste. That is very tasty, very yummy. Just cinnamon and butter. And on an apple, baked apple in the campfire coals. Now it's Lonnie's turn.
That's a great ending to a great meal. Excellent. Really good.
So thank you for joining us on this one and watching this video with us. And this is something that we hope that you'll try when you're out with your family around the campfire. Baked apple in the campfire coals. We'll see you guys all later on the next video. Bye-bye.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.